To our big story this morning, days after Mumbai's former top cop Parambir Singh's letter accused Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh of extortion, the Mahavikas Aghadi government has decided to stand by its Home Minister, putting speculation to rest over the resignation of Anil Deshmukh. In the crucial alliance meeting at NCP Chief Sharad Pawar's residence in the capital, the alliance partners came to a decision that Parambir's letter reeks of a political conspiracy. NCP leadership in the meeting asked if Deshmukh resigned. The BJP will level some other allegations against another minister. This is coming after Deshmukh told party high command that no such incident has happened and termed Parambir's charges vendetta after his transfer.
He made the allegations, which is a prerogative of the chief minister to take appropriate decision. And CM has full authority to take decision regarding allegations, inquiry about these allegations.
अनिल देशमुख की रेजिग्नेशन की कोई आवश्यकता नहीं है। हमारी ATS पूरा छानबीन के तपास कर रही है और हमें पूरा विश्वास है कि उसमें से हम कल्प्रिट कौन है वो जल्द से जल्द ढूंढ के निकालेंगे।
क्या अनिल देशमुख बने रहेंगे अपने पद पर?
देखिए, अनिल देशमुख बने रहेंगे या नहीं बने रहेंगे मुख्यमंत्री बता सकते हैं। कैबिनेट के प्रमुख है, वो मुख्यमंत्री है। पवार साहब ने भी यही कहा ना कि निर्णय मुख्यमंत्री का होता है कि अपने कैबिनेट में किसको रखना है या किसको निकालना है, वो तो मुख्यमंत्री का अधिकार होता है।
संजय जी, ये भी कहा जा रहा है कि वसूली का धंधा चल रहा था और ट्रांसफर पोस्टिंग, देवेंद्र फडणवीस ने कहा है कि पूर्व जो DG थे देसवाल, वो डेपुटेशन पे केंद्र में आए, उन्होंने भी आरोप लगाया कि पोस्टिंग का धंधा चल रहा था, ट्रांसफर पोस्टिंग।
देखिए, कौन क्या कहते हैं अपोजिशन के लोग, उसके ऊपर ध्यान नहीं देना चाहिए। अपोजिशन का धंधा होता है इस प्रकार के आरोप करना, यह उनकी रोजी रोटी होती है। अगर इस प्रकार से वो आरोप नहीं करेंगे उनको कौन पूछेगा?
Former Mumbai top cop Parambir Singh's bombshell letter has Mahavikas Aghadi government on the back foot now. As BJP corners the Uddhav government, Congress and NCP hint towards a BJP hand. Here's more.
An explosive letter. And now it's verified. In a mega India Today exclusive, shunted Mumbai Police Commissioner Parambir Singh confirmed to India Today that he indeed wrote the letter indicting Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh. His clarification puts to rest theories which said the letter may not have been genuine since it was unsigned and sent from an unofficial ID of Parambir Singh.
सर, ये जो लेटर को लेकर काफी बवाल हो रहा है एंड इट्स बीन सेड दैट लेटर हैज नॉट बीन सेंट फ्रॉम योर ऑफिशियल ID व्हिच इज रजिस्टर्ड विद द गवर्नमेंट, योर ईमेल व्हिच यू हैव सेंट टू द चीफ मिनिस्टर, डेप्यूटी चीफ मिनिस्टर एंड अदर्स।
यस, इट्स माय ईमेल ID, दैट्स ऑल, आई हैव नो मोर कमेंट्स।
द NCP हाउएवर रिफ्यूजेस टू सी परमबीर एज अ विसिल ब्लोअर and terms him a pawn in a conspiracy to dethrone Aghadi government.
In his briefing to me and his letter which I read, there is no information about actually collection of money or actually money has been transferred or handed to CM and not CM.
Deshmukh, who had earlier rejected Parambir's charge, today came out with a point-by-point rebuttal, questioning why was Parambir silent till now, rejecting charges that he tries to influence cops bypassing the commissioner. Congress too hinted at a possible BJP hand.
ज्या पद्धतीचे आरोप केले जात आहेत ते बेजबाबदारपणे केले जात आहेत। भारतीय जनता पक्षाचे दोन दोन मापदंड आहेत, स्वतःकरता एक आणि दुसऱ्याकरता वेगळा। त्यामुळे अत्यंत बेजबाबदार पद्धतीनं विरोधी पक्ष काम करत आहे।
शिवसेना मीनवाइल इज इन अ डॅमेज कंट्रोल।
जो कल की घटना हुई है, जो लेटर आया है, जो लेटर लिखा है कमिश्नर, एक्स कमिश्नर, उससे सरकार को कोई खतरा है? जरूर सरकार में अंदर अंदरूनी कुछ बदलाव हो सकते हैं, जरूर बदलाव हो सकते हैं और बदलना भी चाहिए।
While Parambir continues to be praised and panned, his big claims certainly seem to have unmasked the unholy Khadi Khaki nexus. With inputs from Sahil Joshi and Mustafa Sheikh and Pankaj Upadhyay in Mumbai, Bureau Report, India Today.
As elections near in Tamil Nadu, the battle gets more personal. Mounting the attack, Chief Minister Edappadi Palaniswamy taunted Stalin, saying that Karunanidhi did not believe in Stalin, as during his last days when Karunanidhi was unwell, he did not give the party to Stalin. EPS said that if this is the case, then how will people believe in Stalin? His remarks came after Stalin termed AIADMK a slave party of the BJP. Stalin proclaimed that no AIADMK leader should win the elections, as it will be a victory for the BJP. Just days before Bengal goes for phase one of polls, Home Minister Amit Shah released BJP Sonar Bangla Sankalp Patrika. It promises 33% job quota to women in government jobs and vows to implement CAA in the first cabinet meeting. Here's a complete report coming in.
Days before West Bengal goes for 8-phase elections, Home Minister Amit Shah released BJP's Sonar Bangla Sankalp Patra, going all out to woo Bengal with its governance vision. Promising 33% reservation to women in government jobs and free education to girl child from KG to PG, trying to dent Mamta's women vote bank.
बंगाल सरकार जो भारतीय जनता पार्टी की बढ़ेगी बनेगी वो उठाएगी। मित्रों, सबसे पहले हम राज्य सरकार की सभी नौकरियों में महिलाओं को 33% आरक्षण देकर महिलाओं का
The manifesto also promised implementation of CAA in the first cabinet meet.
70 साल से जो शरणार्थी यहां पर आकर बसे हैं, जिनको इनके मन में दर्द है कि हम वहां से शरणार्थी बनकर आए, आज हमारी नागरिकता नहीं, 70 साल से वो अवैध तरीके से रहे हैं, सिटीजनशिप अमेंडमेंट एक्ट को पहली ही कैबिनेट में लागू कर वो सभी को नागरिकता देने का काम भारतीय जनता पार्टी।
इट ऑल्सो प्रॉमिस टू कर्ब इनफिल्ट्रेशन इन स्टेट बाय सीलिंग द पोरस बॉर्डर्स. In a bid to create a global film industry in Bengal, the vision document promised financial assistance to Bengali film industry and promised a Nobel-like Tagore Award and global Satyajit Ray Awards like the Oscars.
Nobel Prize ki tarz par, Tagore Prize aur Oscar ki tarz par Satyajit Ray International Award ki sthapna karkar Bengal ka sanskritik vaibhav wapis lane ki mang kari.
Amit Shah also hit out at incumbent TMC government, accusing it of doing nothing for the state in past 10 years and urged voters to give BJP a chance.
Tino partiyon ne milkar Bengal ko azadi ke waqt jahan the wahan se niche lane ka kaam kiya hai. Ek 5 saal Narendra Modi ji ko de dijiye, hum Sonar Bangla ke nirman ka vaada karte hain.
Trinamool Congress hitting back termed the BJP manifesto a stunt by outsiders to fool Bengal.
BJP sob boktobbo guli hocche jumla e kotha bola ar seta ora Gujarati Amit Shah ke diye koriyechen tiro banglay bolte parlen na banglar manusher kache hindi te puro boktita dilen bangali jara chilen tara chup kore royechen.
With days left in Bengal elections, the biggest question remains: whose manifesto will manage to woo the voters? With Paulo Misaha in Kolkata, Bureau Report, India Today.
As the election season is approaching, people can be seen flouting COVID protocols during rallies and campaigning in all poll-bound states. This is coming as a fear of a second wave concerns everybody. Here is a hair-raising news report.
Tamil Nadu CM EPS campaigning in Polur, with a sea of supporters thronging his vehicle. The massive crowd on Sunday without any social distancing, masks or COVID-appropriate behaviour. Zero social distancing at Stalin's massive yatra in Tirupur. Crowds thronging pole rallies in huge numbers amid the mega COVID surge. Zero social distancing at Mamta's Padyatras in Bengal. Zero social distancing at the BJP president's campaign events in Bengal. And even in Assam, this enormous crowd for BJP leader Himanta Biswa Sharma. No social distancing, hardly any mask, and zero apparent care for a pandemic that has just begun to surge again in the country. Take a closer look at these hair-raising images. You can easily tell that arm's length distance, masks and basic COVID protocols have been thrown to the wind.
স্বনিধি যোজনার সুবিধা যত দ্রুত সম্ভব পাইয়ে দেওয়া হবে.
All this at a time when India is fighting to ensure a second wave doesn't overwhelm the country. With elections in five states, the priority is resoundingly crowds over COVID. Doctors and healthcare experts have once again warned against this spectacular letting down of guard. While the fight for votes is an overpowering draw, experts are still perplexed about how last year's Bihar election crowds, with zero distancing and masks, didn't lead to a huge explosion of COVID cases. But experts believe that is no excuse. With the teeth of a second wave digging in, and with testing numbers in states like Bengal still uncertain, the room for error and complacency have never been lower. Bureau Report, India Today.
Maharashtra's worrying coronavirus surge continued on Sunday. The state has recorded 30,535 cases, crossing the 30,000 mark for the first time since the outbreak of the pandemic. Maharashtra recorded 99 deaths, taking the death toll to 53,399. Mumbai recorded its highest ever cases, registering 3,775 cases and 10 deaths on Sunday. Meanwhile, Pune, Nashik, Aurangabad, Nagpur also reported the highest single day cases ever. Maharashtra has seen 1,81,889 fresh cases in the last 8 days. So far, 43 lakh people have been vaccinated in the state thus far. Karnataka is amongst the worst impacted states from coronavirus as the cases continue to surge in the state. According to the state health minister, the second wave of the virus has begun in the state. Now, amidst the massive surge in COVID cases, popular film actor Puneet Rajkumar violated COVID norms to promote his upcoming film. While addressing a promotional event in Hubali, the actor gathered a large crowd with no face mask and social distancing. This event comes on a day when the state reported as many as 1,715 fresh cases and 7 deaths, taking the total tally of active cases to over 12,800 and the death toll to over 12,400. These are some worrying figures that are coming in. Both the Karnataka Chief Minister and Health Minister appealed to the people to exercise caution.
ರಾತ್ರಿ ಹೊತ್ತಿರ್ಬೋದು, ದಿನದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅನಗತ್ಯವಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಚಟುವಟಿಕೆಗಳು, ಊಟಗಳು, ಸಮಾರಂಭಗಳು, ಪಾರ್ಟಿಗಳು, ಇದೆಲ್ಲವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಕಡಿವಾಣ ಮಾಡಿ. ಒಂದು ತಿಂಗಳು, ಎರಡು ತಿಂಗಳು, ಇವತ್ತು ಎರಡನೇ ಅಲೆ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ನಿಯಂತ್ರಣ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಸೇರಿ ಮಾಡೋಣ.
ಟೈಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಸೆಗ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಗುಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಗ್ಲಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಅ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್.
Here is the good news of the day when it comes to the COVID-19 pandemic. In spite of a big surge in many parts of the country, including Maharashtra and Punjab, India's case fatality rate, as far as COVID-19 is concerned, continues to be among the lowest in the world. In fact, it is even lower than the world average. Right now, it stands at 1.39%. It has been unchanged for a very, very long time. Maharashtra and Punjab also, which are seeing a massive surge in cases, have a rather stable case fatality rate. Delhi too is seeing a surge and the positivity rate has gone up to 1%, but the case fatality rate continues to be low. Here is the bad news of the day when it comes to the COVID-19 pandemic. India is seeing a crisis and a four-month high when it comes to the total number of new cases being reported on a daily basis. More than 43,000 new infections are being reported in the country right now. Maharashtra is accounting for more than 50% of these infections. Hospitals in Maharashtra are filling up very quickly. Delhi too has started to see a surge in the total number of cases being reported on a daily basis. The positivity rate has also gone up to 1%. In fact, lockdowns have returned to many parts of the country. Here is the ugly news of the day when it comes to the pandemic. In spite of several warnings and in spite of instructions being given out to the Uttarakhand government, there are cases that are getting reported from Mahakumbh. What's worse is that the Chief Minister of Uttarakhand, Tirath Singh Rawat, has gone on to the extent of saying that nobody is going to be stopped because there is a pandemic and faith is going to help overcome the virus. The central government is not amused because all COVID-19 protocol is being thrown out of the window. The centre has written to the Uttarakhand government to do the needful, given the fact that the central teams that were sent to Uttarakhand to oversee the preparations for Mahakumbh have been very, very dissatisfied with what they saw there in terms of COVID protocol being completely ignored, being neglected by the devotees there, and the Uttarakhand government also looking the other way.
At the start of the series, Virat Kohli mentioned about changing India's approach in T20 cricket. They lost the series opener, but by the time the fifth match got over, Team India may have found the formula for T20 cricket that they were looking for with their sights on T20 World Cup. Here's a look.
Kohli opening the batting for India.
There was a formula that India was looking to explore in T20 cricket.
Some might say two of the finest white ball players in the game.
This time around, you'll see guys being a bit more free, a bit more expressive in terms of, approaching the innings and playing more freely, not worried about whether we have enough batsmen to take care of things if we lose a couple of wickets early or not, which was the case before, to be honest. We didn't have enough depth in the batting to be able to play freely throughout the first 10 or 12 overs. But I see us being much more positive and free from this series onwards.
Very first game of the series against England's best playing 11 and India were all at sea, managing just 124. Many thought that the formula that India was looking for has gone for a toss. A young Ishan Kishan got his maiden international opportunity and it worked wonders, with India showing they were capable of doing what the best T20 sides are doing.
And here we go again. It's short, it's picked up and it's smashed over deep square for six. Straight away.
By the end of the third game, India were once again down, but another new face, this time Suryakumar Yadav, followed the template that India had wished for. Batting first, India got 285 in the fourth T20 international and bowlers did their job to take the series into the deciding fifth game. Until now, Virat had sacrificed his usual number three spot for others, but this time, the Indian skipper took the onus on himself and opened the innings with his deputy Rohit Sharma. India's two best batsmen got to play the most number of deliveries and the result was a mammoth 224 for 2 on the board for India.
Oh, once again in the air briefly, but well timed for 4.
Now it's about your two best players getting maximum number of balls in T20 cricket. So I would definitely like to partner Rohit at the top, because as I rightly said, if we have a partnership and we both are set, then you know that one of us are going to cause some serious damage, and that's exactly what we want. And the other guys feel much more confident when one of us is still in and set, and they know that they can play more freely. So it augurs well for the team. I would like this to continue and hopefully continue that form through to the World Cup.
With two young guns doing incredibly well in their maiden appearances for India, and Virat and Rohit at the top, Team India would surely fancy their chances come October when they play the T20 World Cup at home.
Let's go through with the shot.
During the journey from 124 in the first game to 224 in the fifth T20, India may have found the formula that Virat was talking about at the start of the series.
Last eight series, India won seven.
Sports Bureau, India Today.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.